eyes are on the US inflation print today. Investors are confident that inflation in the US eased last month, so the US dollar is softer while equities and gold are stronger into the data. So let's see if the data is good enough to keep the Federal Reserve hawks at bay. So welcome, this is Swissquote's daily market talk. So global indices made a solid start to the week. The EuroStoxx 600 closed yesterday 1.76% higher on news that the Ukrainians are doing quite well, pushing back the Russian army in territories they launch a counteroffensive attack, while the S&P 500 and Nasdaq advanced more than 1% each of them. The S&P 500 even registers its strongest four-day rally since June and recovered half of the August to September losses, and that even with the chatter that a rail strike in the US could put pressure on supply chains in the US in the coming days and cost around $2 billion to the US economy per day. So an eventual strike would disrupt the retail industry and weigh heavily on the US retail giants and logistics companies' profit expectations, for example. So I would say companies like Amazon, Walmart, Target, Home Depot, FedEx, and UPS would clearly be on the chopping block. Plus, the latest news that we hear these days doesn't point at a great holiday season for retailers in the US either. MasterCard spending polls, for example, projects around 7% rise in this holiday sales season, less than 8.5% realized last year, given that there will certainly be more promotions this year to allow the retailers to sell their building inventories. And well, the latest projections from MasterCard are not even adjusted for inflation. So it's surprising that none of these companies that I just named before posted losses yesterday, except for Home Depot. Amazon, for example, jumped near 2.40% at yesterday's trading session. This is the fourth consecutive session of gains for Amazon, and well, three of them ended with Amazon gaining more than 2%. So as I said yesterday, hope of seeing another soft inflation data in the US seems to be the major catalyzer of gains for the last couple of sessions. This is why we actually see the retailers gain as well. And add to that Janet Yellen's words that the US could actually avoid a recession with some good luck. There is obviously nothing to stop the bulls right now. So today is the US Inflation Day, and the US Inflation Day is now the new NFP Day, as inflation is the data which has the biggest influence on Federal Reserve expectations since the Fed declared war against inflation by the end of last year. According to market estimates, the US inflation is seen easing toward 8.1% in August versus 8.5% printed a month earlier and 9.1% peak printed the month before. So a second month of soft inflation read in the US has actually the power to soften the Federal Reserve hawks and increase the bets of softer interest rates hikes in the US beyond September, because as I said at yesterday's episode, odds for September's FOMC meeting won't change even with a significantly soft inflation read today. The Fed is almost fully expected to raise the interest rates by another 75 basis points at next week's FOMC meeting. Full stop. What will happen after is, however, up to the data. Therefore, as I said, a sufficiently soft and ideally softer than expected inflation read today should boost the Federal Reserve dose and give some further support to the bullish price action that we see in equity markets these days. Whereas a figure above expectations, or God forbid, a figure above last month's read, for example, could snap the latest rally in equities and send the stock market tumbling. We are now tilted toward a softer read than otherwise, as the house prices in the US and rents started falling. The wages in the US stagnate. The Chinese producer prices actually pointed at a sharp retreat recently. The used car prices retreat as well in the US, and gasoline prices continue softening as well. And more importantly, inflation expectations in the US continue their steep fall. So for an economist and for Jerome Powell, obviously, inflation expectations are almost more important than the actual inflation levels themselves, because inflation expectations are believed to be a major driver of future inflation. When inflation expectations are high, people ask higher salaries. Companies offer higher pay rises, obviously, to keep people to work for them. They increase prices more easily for their products as well. And as such, the expectations become reality. It's a very, very strongly self-fulfilling area, this inflation. And as Jerome Powell said, one of the Federal Reserve's biggest fears is to find themselves in this positive inflation expectations spiral. But happily, that is not the case for now. The New York Fed survey of consumer expectations showed yesterday about half a percentage point decline in August. This is a remarkable monthly decline, mind you, in the survey's 9-year history, as it is the second biggest drop after July's record-breaking drop. So we can say that the things are quite going well in the direction that the Federal Reserve wants them to go. So today's inflation figure is this week's biggest data, obviously, because we only talk about inflation, and we will obviously be watching very, very closely this data. What's really sad, actually, is that we won't get to know what the Federal Reserve officials think about the latest CPI figure, because obviously they have to keep quiet before next week's FOMC meeting and the FOMC decision. Now, hope of the soft inflation data is also what's pulling the US dollar softer these days across the board. The US dollar index tipped a toe below the 108 mark at yesterday's trading session, while the euro dollar made an attempt above its 50-day moving average level, as news that the Ukrainian troops are now being successful in their counteroffensive attack and the chatter that voices are rising in within Russia against the regime's strategy in Ukraine somehow brought forward the possibility of Russia being defeated in Ukraine. So this morning, we see that the euro dollar is consolidating above that critical 50-day moving average level, which stands at around 101 level. A softer inflation read in the US could actually cement gains above the 50-day moving average for the euro dollar, and this is all we hope, really. Likewise, cable first with the 117 level this morning, despite a softer than expected GDP read yesterday in the UK. The British economy grew just 0.2% last month, as industrial production actually shrank despite expectations of a slight expansion. And well, the outlook for the third quarter is rather dull for the UK. It's said that just another day off for Queen Elizabeth's funeral on September 19th, for example, is enough to tip the UK economy into recession. So imagine how bad things are in the UK right now. And even the hawkish expectations for the Bank of England, which was basically supposed to meet this week, but which will finally meet next week due to the Queen's death and funeral, may not be enough actually to strengthen the pound's back in the medium run. We could still see the sterling gain some territory against the broadly softer US dollar if obviously the US dollar continues softening, but we actually now expect the euro to extend its advance against the pound sterling toward the 0.88 level, which was last seen on February last year. Elsewhere, the dollar Swiss retreated to 0.95 level, and the USD CAD slipped below 130, the loonie being also boosted by firmer crude oil prices yesterday. So speaking of that, the American crude rallied more than 2% at yesterday's trading session on improved market sentiment, and actually flirted with the $90 offers without, however, being able to clear them. It is possible we see an attempt above that $90 level in the next few sessions if obviously the risk rally persists across the broader markets. In the precious metals, gold advanced to $1,735 per ounce and could actually test the 50-day moving average near $1,740 level if the US dollar continues softening. Silver, on the other hand, flirts with the $20 offers and could well extend its advance if today's inflation data is soft enough to keep the Federal Reserve hawks at bay and the US dollar appetite contained. So it's all about the US dollar. It's all about the US inflation today. So this is all for today. I'm Ipekos Kardeşkaya, and thanks for joining me and for all your comments and reactions, which actually make these episodes a real Market Talk. So I hope this episode of Market Talk has also been helpful and has been insightful to you. So please do not not hesitate to leave your comments, your reactions and your questions below as usual, and follow us on Instagram, on Twitter and on LinkedIn for regular market updates, and subscribe of course to our YouTube channel for daily market comments. I meet you again tomorrow, and until then, good day trading.